Click subscribe to get latest news and don't forget to press the bell icon.
Starbucks sure knows how to pick left-wing CEOs. The coffee chain giant had, until recently, Howard Schultz as CEO. You might remember Howard. He is a hardcore liberal who vocally supported Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton in their presidential races. He famously dismissed supporters of traditional marriage when he said any Starbucks investor who didn't support gay marriage should sell their shares and take their business elsewhere. Yeah, that guy. Schultz recently stepped down as CEO, but still remains the executive chairman. Starbucks finally found his replacement, however, when they recently announced that Rosalind Brewer would serve as the new CEO of Starbucks. Brewer served as CEO of Sam's Club until earlier this year. It was an announcement hailed by many in the business community, but not all, as Brewer has a history of controversial statements. In particular, it appears she gets triggered by the sight of white guys in boardrooms. It all goes back to an interview she gave CNN in 2015, in which she seemed to have a problem with too many white men in corporate America. The Washington Post reported on a particular exchange in the interview. CNN's Poppy Harlow asked her about what it would take to see more women at the top of corporate America. Brewer answered, "My executive team is very diverse, and I make that a priority," she told Harlow. "I demand it of my team and within the structure. And then, every now and then, you have to nudge your partners, and you have to speak up and speak out. And I try to use my platform for that. I try to set an example. I try to mentor many women inside my company and outside the company because I think it's important. And I talk to my suppliers about it. Just today we met with a supplier, and the entire other side of the table was all Caucasian males. That was interesting. I decided not to talk about it directly with the suppliers, folks in the room because there were actually no females, like, levels down. So I'm going to place a call to him." Starbucks can afford to be more diverse, because as a high-profile corporation, they have access to the best and the brightest candidates in business. They are more likely to find the diversity they want. Her supplier, on the other hand, could be far smaller, and if it is in a labor-intensive industry like printing coffee cups or manufacturing restaurant tables, it only makes sense that men would dominate the leadership. If it is a regional company, they may be limited in their workforce, so geographically, they may be pulling 90% white guys as potential employees. In that context, complaining about the makeup of a company's leadership is unwarranted. Had she discovered that her supplier had a reputation of discrimination, however, then she should have used her power as CEO to affect change. The way she described the situation, she seemed like someone prone to knee-jerk, politically correct overreactions. So she should fit right in at Starbucks.